The human race, we're a wonderful species, but at the same time, we also don't have a great track record. We're trapped in a growth spiral. Growth in the population, in markets, in profits. And I think this spiral is almost unstoppable.
We built towns 100 years ago to provide the labor force for factories for the Industrial Revolution. Now we need to look at how we build towns so people live a healthy lifestyle.
The resources of the earth are progressively decreasing so much that it is not sure that for the future generation there will be enough. So this target is, at the present time, a target for science.
Science is all about knowing more. If you know more, you have more solutions, more possibilities.
As temperature rises, it's actually expected that soil organic matter in tundra is going to become a major atmospheric CO2 and methane source. So understanding the role of microbes in that process is going to help us to better constrain and make predictions about what's going to happen. One thing that's actually been worked on a lot are biofuels, right? And so one thing that's being looked at is engineering microbes, and that is engineering their physiology, their biochemistry, which is what I'm interested in, to make value-added products and to make them from CO2 that's directly in the atmosphere rather than from petrochemical feedstocks. That's the one that I think has the most potential in the short term to actually make an influence and make these things now from new carbon rather than old carbon that's been in the ground for hundreds of millions of years.
The buildings in Europe, for example, consume about 40% of the energy. So it's a large proportion of the energy use. And the heating and the cooling is a large part of this 40%. By improving the efficiency of these systems, we can cut down on the energy use. Looking forward to net zero energy buildings. That means buildings that are efficient and can produce energy from renewable sources.
We're living on a planet at the moment where there are about 7 billion people, and there are conservative estimates that the population is going to grow to about 9 billion by 2050. So clearly we're going to have to try to produce more food on less land. So in terms of agricultural biotechnology, we can make crops which can be used by small-scale farmers to produce higher yield and therefore give people a better living whilst still producing more food for the population as a whole.
There's a critical need for increased agricultural productivity with reduced inputs to the system in terms of fertilizers and also water. I think the thing that I'm most excited about are genome editing approaches, from the standpoint that it's going to allow people who've been doing basically protein biochemistry, which is what we do, to take that work and really apply it in a very broad sense. And it's simply a modification of the DNA of that plant that could be found in natural variants, and so there's no foreign DNA involved.
There is quite a lot of work within psychosocial studies on the denial of climate change.
We already know that when we make choices, we tend to overweight options that have immediate and certain consequences over things that have delayed and uncertain consequences. So this phenomenon is known as delayed discounting. And if you think about it, it is probably at the heart of many of the problems that we confront when we think about sustainability.
Virtual reality gives people first-hand direct experiences, and they tend to respond as if it's real. So we're going to take them through to the future of how they might be in 10 years' time, and how in 20 years' time they might be also with their children, based on scientific predictions of what global warming is going to be likely to be causing, giving people the experience that relates to them personally, and hope that this can lead not just to an abstract opinion that, yes, I agree that sustainability is important, but actually lead to people wanting to take action.
30% of our food is being wasted. It has to be the private and the public sector playing together in this domain in order to make things happen.
The greenhouse gas emissions need to come down. There's no question about that. That is a mitigation priority that we must take very seriously. And it needs scientists to inform us about the ways in which that can be done through innovation, through new research. It needs governments to put in legislation, but critically it needs businesses.
Scientists should be involved, must be involved in this kind of discussion much more than they have been until now.
I think that sustainability will depend on the capability of all stakeholders to work together.
We transmit, but somebody has to receive. Or we do, but somebody has to ask. So finally, we need a dialogue that has to be increased.
No one's expert in the whole range of areas that global warming covers. And therefore, by working together, we can make predictions that politicians and the public have to listen to, because it's based on grounded interdisciplinary science.
I find very important that research and results from research that can be relevant for sustainability is accessible to businesses.
Data, open information, open protocols are all going to be key to getting solutions and getting science out to industries, out to governments, and out to people that might actually be able to translate it.
The more people who have access to reliable knowledge, reliable understandings, and can access it easily, the more quickly we can understand how to change the way we do business, the business of living on Earth, to a more sustainable path.
The quick advancements in research and in knowledge, this is the only way we can overcome all our problems we have, because time is a very important factor.
There's so many scientific solutions out there already today. All we really need to do is to make them freely and efficiently accessible to researchers, policymakers, companies, anyone really. And this will allow us then to implement the type of radically new products that are profitable and as well move us towards a sustainable society.